name is Ariana Gomez. I am the Public Relations and Marketing Manager for the LA Fashion District Business Improvement District. And I've been here for about 3 years now.
For a lot of people who don't know what a bid office is or what they do, is there a quick maybe definition of what all bids kind of encompass and what their purpose is in the city?
Most business improvement districts are nonprofits. We actually have a couple in downtown LA, but we have them all over the world. Most districts are centered around city centers where the bids are created around shopping destinations, but it still has a community feeling. We're different because we are industry related. It's, you know, us, the LA Fashion District, and then the Garment District in New York.
I think a lot of people are confused on how it's different, right?
Yeah.
They come here and they think Fashion District is Santee Alley, and it's like, no, that's only a part of it.
That is just two blocks of the 100-block Fashion District. Perfect. So it used to be that where we are right now, where the new Mart is, this was the center of the Fashion District.
Really?
And it used to be that these buildings were filled with manufacturing. But as manufacturing started moving overseas, these buildings slowly started converting to wholesale. The Fashion District was created by the property owners, where the property owners saw the value in their properties go down because there was so much crime downtown and everyone had the big roll down gates, and once, you know, 5 o'clock came around, this place was a ghost town. And so the bid didn't exist, and we were actually one of the first bids to be established in California.
I'm Ken Smith. I'm the executive director of the LA Fashion District Business Improvement District, but we just call ourselves the Fashion District. And we're very proud of the fact that we were the first property-based business improvement district in the city of LA, and indeed in LA County. When I say property-based, I mean that property owners actually assess themselves, so it's over and above what they pay on the property taxes, to provide dollars to perform programs and services over and above what the city provides. I arrived at the Fashion District. I know nothing about fashion. I'm still green under the years in fashion, even though I've been here for a long while. So my background is planning. I think we're gonna see a more pedestrian-friendly Fashion District. We're gonna see more bicycles. We're gonna see bike share coming soon. Here we are. This is the second largest city in North America. And Los Angeles in 1999 was probably 20 years behind most any other downtown in the United States. We are the first business improvement district in the county. There's now 35 of them in the city of LA alone. There are 8 different BIDs in downtown. The one thing that's sort of been the thread through the district from its very beginning to now is clean and safe.
Our bid does clean and save programs. We pick up about 6 tons of trash a day. We power wash, we remove graffiti, and we have a safety patrol team that kind of serves as our ambassadors. So when people can't remember where they park, or if a business owner runs into any kind of issue throughout the day and they need some assistance, our safe team is there for that. Our safe team also deals with homeless.
I think the issue of homelessness is one that has been a challenge in the city of LA for decades. We have one of the largest street homeless populations in North America. City decision makers and county decision makers decades ago decided to try to concentrate that population in Skid Row, which is, you know, in downtown LA. And we've been spending a lot of money and time and effort to manage street homelessness, but not to end it. Ending it really requires housing. We're really proud in the Fashion District that we've seen the construction of over 200 units that have been basically dedicated to homeless individuals. And the key there is it's not just a home, but it's also services that come with that housing unit. Those 150 people, those people that are in Skid Row, they're mentally ill. They're often drug addicted. They're not going to be reaching out and walking through doors to ask for housing. I know our board is having active discussions now as to whether or not we will look at finding some people who will actually, on a one-on-one basis, the professionals who will reach out to those people, and if we can connect them to some housing resources that the county has recently provided funding for, that we can actually get these people off the street. Before the bid existed, there really was no real spokesperson for the community.
Most of our businesses are mom and pop shops. So, you know, they are five people trying to run a company and they don't necessarily have time to do marketing, so we try to help them get the word out. We have a blog on our website where we feature new stores every week. And it's all divided by category, so if you're looking for fabrics, you can go in and click the fabrics link. To find out more about the Fashion District and the Fashion District bid, you can go to fashiondistrict.org. If you have any questions, you can shoot us an email, info@fashiondistrict.org. We're also on Facebook as LA Fashion District. We're on Twitter as LA Fashion DIST. We're on Instagram as LA Fashion District as well.
You know, really, we are the future of fashion, because fashion's really about that individualistic California casual but yet edgy style, and I think we're just the epicenter of that. And you know, we're really the wave of the future for fashion, and that's why I think every young designer wants to be here in Los Angeles.